Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Friday, December 17th, starting off today with Amy Grant's song, Breath of Heaven. Always such a beautiful song of this season. So we're going to talk a little bit about that later, but I'm glad you're here now. So let me take a minute to say good morning to all of you. Welcome on this Friday. Third Friday of Advent. Good morning, Donna and Janet. I'm glad you're here holding you in prayer this day. And Priscilla and Barbara, welcome, holding you in prayer as well as we start this day. Good morning, Lisa and Augusta. I'm glad you're both here, holding you in prayer today. And good morning, Gail and Celia. Welcome, holding you in prayer as we start the day together as well. Good morning, Daniel and Vinette. I'm glad you're here, holding you in prayer. And Blanca and Macon, I'm glad you're here too, holding you both in prayer. Good morning, Esther and Marion. Welcome, holding you in prayer. And good morning, Marilyn. And I'll be praying for you as you get your procedure on your eye today, holding you in prayer. Good morning, Georgiana, and good morning, Betty. It's good to have you both here today, holding you in prayer. And good morning, Lavake. I'm glad you're here too. Holding you in prayer, holding all of your families in prayer as we start this day together. So today our devotion comes from Matthew, although I started off with Mary. We're going to talk a little bit about the wise men, but we'll get back to Mary as well because it's all part of the story. Matthew 2, 1 through 2. Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 2. That's where we're going to be today. And our devotion is entitled, The Birth of Jesus Means That Fear Lost All Its Power. So why do we keep giving back what the manger took away? So as you turn to Matthew 2, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I am blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. We're located on the corner of George and Liberty in the heart of our city. And I am so glad you're with us this morning. So let's look at Matthew 2, 1 through 2, which tells us this. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." So, this devotion comes from Bob Goff's book, Live in Grace, Walk in Love. And today's devotion is entitled, The Birth of Jesus Means That Fear Lost All Its Power. So why do we keep giving back what the manger took away? And this is what he says. He says, right after Jesus was born, some wise men from the east went to Jerusalem to find him. They saw his star and knew it meant the Messiah had come. Herod the king was furious. He felt threatened by Jesus because he knew this baby was more powerful than him. He ordered the wise men to go find Jesus and then report back with his location. Herod had evil plans in mind to put an end to Jesus' life. The wise men were under the king's orders to share this information, but when they got to the manger, where love lay fast asleep, everything changed. They knelt to the ground and offered gifts. Any fears they brought with them went away once they saw the face of love. The wise men tricked the king to save the life of Jesus. They went back to their home country by an alternate route. Sometimes in order to obey God, we need to disobey Herod. Most of us will never have to fear for our lives the way the wise men did. But we still let fear get the best of us. Fear keeps us from following our passions because we're afraid we might fail. It keeps us from giving love away because we're afraid of vulnerability. We fear judgment and disapproval. We fear the unknown. But just like the wise men who changed when they came face to face with love in the manger, we can put fear in its place. When we love people more than we love failure, disappointment, and even death, love wins. I'm going to say it again. When we love people more than we fear failure, disappointment, and even death, love wins. We don't have to fear less. We need to love more. We don't have to fear less. We have to love more. So today the question is, what can you do today to place the fears you have at the feet of Jesus? This is a tough one for so many of us. We live in a world of fear. Fear for the future. I mean, I'm always amazed when I talk to young people about how much fear they feel about the future of our world, whether it's the environment, whether we will even have it, or their fear about our economy, our fears around whether this pandemic will come to an end, our fears for our children. I remember when I was pregnant with Sean in 1999. It was making me feel old. When I was pregnant with Sean in 1999, that was the year, I remember when we were going into the year 2000, and Y2K, I can remember feeling like, I'm carrying this baby, why am I doing this? Like, we don't even know what will happen. They kept saying the computers were gonna shut things off and all these nuclear things were gonna go off and it was the end of the world. I remember thinking, what did I get myself into? Why would I have a child in this time? And it brings me back to Mary's story and that song that I played at the beginning when she says, I am frightened of the load I bear. I remember that feeling like, what have I gotten myself into? Should I have done this at this time? And I can't imagine what Mary must have felt as she carried her child, she carried the Son of God, as she had to travel from her home all the way down to Bethlehem, how much of a burden that must have felt like. But the greater burden was she worthy of this? Was she capable of this? This is something all of us think about. This is something all of us struggle with. Whether we're a woman or a man or whatever it is, whatever challenges we face, there's always this voice that tells us, that we need to fear, right? But the manger tells us something different. The manger, and we heard that in today's devotion, the manger tells us that love is more powerful than fear. And so I love the song I started with, because she calls for the breath of heaven to hold her together. So I'm gonna ask you today to focus on breath, even though the question was, what do you need to lay? We all know what our fears are. We know what we need to lay down. We lay it down and we pick it back up. So what I really would like you to do is to breathe. Whenever you begin to feel any mounting fears or concerns or frustrations, take a breath, but not just any breath. Be reminded that the very breath that runs through our lungs is the breath of heaven. We were given God's ruach, God's breath. And we, breath, our breath is life-giving, but it also heals. It is very healing. So for Mary to ask, I know this is a song, it's not in the scripture, but I love it. For Mary to ask for the breath of heaven to hold her together, I'm gonna ask you to do that today. Anytime, maybe you wanna plan out when you're gonna breathe. We breathe all the time. Maybe you're gonna plan out when you're gonna focus on your breath, but maybe you just remember when things begin to mount, when you begin to fear or be concerned about things that are happening in your life, or when you turn on the news and all of the news cycle is anxiety producing. Ask for the breath of heaven to fill your lungs, to fill your heart, to remind you that fear is powerless in the face of God's love for you this day. So ask for the breath of heaven to hold you together this day. Let us pray. God, we come before you today acknowledging that too often we have allowed fear to run our lives, to make our decisions, to hold us back. And so today, Lord, we come before the manger, seeking your love. Lord, melt away all of those fears, all of the anxieties, all of the things that hinder us from experiencing your love, the things that have hidden us away, the things that have kept us from experiencing the full life that you offer us. Remind us this day that your breath, the very breath of heaven, is given to us. Help us, Lord, to experience that breath so that the fears we have might turn into a depth of love, a reminder of your love for us, and a call for us to love others the way that we have been loved. This day, Lord, help us to find moments to breathe in your breath, to know that you are here with us, Emmanuel, that we might let go of those fears and trust more fully in your love this day. We ask all of this, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So, take moments to breathe in the breath of heaven this day, when your fears and anxieties, when your concerns for the future mount. Take a breath. Take a breath. So I was a little wrong yesterday. I mean, I was wrong yesterday. I did not do yesterday's devotion. I wrote today's devotion, so I hope you enjoy it. It kind of lends itself. It's on Mary. And it does lend itself to today's devotion that I shared with you here So that'll come up on Facebook, as well as some of you will get it in the mail too. So I hope you enjoy that. And I look forward to being with all of you tomorrow morning for prayer and devotion, holding all of you in prayer. God loves you, and so do I. I'll see you back here tomorrow. Bye, friends.